أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صلاة سنة and نافلة أبو درداء رضي الله عنه narrates that Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم in a hadith قدسي said there are three persons whom Allah loves and smiles at them being well pleased with them one who continues to fight in the battlefield alone even when all his companions have deserted him until he is either martyred or receives help from Allah and becomes victorious. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the angels, look at my slave, how he remains steadfast and firm in the battle, only to please me. The second is the one who has an attractive wife besides him on a soft and luxurious bedding. Even then, he gets up to offer tahajjud salah. Allah says to the angels, look, he is sacrificing his pleasures and desires and remembering me. If he so wanted, he would have continued to sleep. There is the third person who is on a journey in a caravan when all the members of the caravan, after traveling till late, are fast asleep. He gets up to perform tahajjud salah willingly or unwillingly. Tabarani, Targhib. Abu Malik al-Ashri radiallahu anhu narrates that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are rooms in paradise, the outside of which can be seen from inside and the inside from the outside. Allah has prepared for those who feed others, spread salam abundantly and offer salah at night when people are sleeping. Ibn Hibban. Sahal bin Saad radiallahu anhuma narrates that Jibreel alayhi salam came to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and submitted, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you may live a very long life, but one day you have to die. Do whatever deeds you wish to do, you will have a return of it. Love whomsoever you wish, but one day you will have to leave him. And know with certainty that undoubtedly the honor of a believer lies in tahajjud and his dignity lies in self-contentment. Tabrani, Targhib. Abdullah bin Amr ibn As radiallahu anhuma narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to me, O Abdullah, do not be like so and so, who used to offer tahajjud at night and then stopped offering it. Bukhari. Note, this hadith implies that without any valid excuse, the deeds in regular practice should not be given up. Mazahir Haq. Muttalib ibn Rabiya radiallahu anhuma narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, tahajjud salah is in twos. When you offer this salah, then recite tashahhud after every two rakat and then remain persistent in imploring Allah by being like a person in extreme need, expressing one's helplessness and weakness. The one who do not do it in this manner, his salah is incomplete. Musnad Ahmad. Note, dua can be asked after tashahhud in the salah as well as after completing the salah. Huzaifa bin Yaman radiallahu anhu narrates that one night I happened to pass Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who was offering salah in the Masjid of Medina. I stood up behind Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to offer salah with him, assuming that he would not be aware of my presence. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was reciting Surah Baqarah. I assumed that he would go for ruku after 100 verses, but he did not do so. I thought that he would go for ruku after 200 verses, but he did not do so. I felt sure he would go for ruku at the end of the surah. So when the surah ended, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said three times, Allahumma lakal hamd, Allahumma lakal hamd, Allahumma lakal hamd, all praise be to you, O Allah. And then started reciting Surah Ali Imran. And I thought after this surah, he would certainly go for ruku. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam completed this surah, he did not go for ruku but said Allahumma lakal hamd and started Surah Ma'idah. I thought that he would go for ruku at the end of this surah and he did perform ruku. And I heard him reciting this tasbih in ruku, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, all glory to my Rabb, the greatest. And from the whispering of his moving lips, I realized that he was undoubtedly reciting something else, which I did not comprehend. Then he went into sajda. I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reciting this tasbih, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, all glory to my Rabb, the most exalted. And something else which I could not understand. In the second rak'ah, he started reciting Surah Anam. I left and went away as I lacked the endurance to continue in Salah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Musannaf Abdul Razzaq. Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma narrates, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reciting this supplication one night after he had completed his tahajjud salah. Translation. O Allah, I ask you of your mercy by which you give guidance to my heart, by which you make my work easy and remove my distress condition by it, and manage my issues in my absence by it, and give exaltation and honor by your mercy, and clean my actions from hypocrisy and infidelity by your mercy, and put that thing in my heart which is correct and suitable for me, and whatever I like grant me by your mercy, and protect me from all evil by your mercy. O Allah, give me that belief and faith after which there may not be any infidelity, and a mercy enabling me to achieve the blessings of your gifts in this world and the hereafter. O Allah, I ask of you to give me a conviction that your decree is the very fulfillment of my aims, and an entertainment which is offered to martyrs, and a life of the fortunate, and your help over enemies. O Allah, I place before you my needs, though my understanding is limited and my actions are weak. Hence, I am badly in need of your mercy. O the maker of affairs and healer of the hearts, as you by your power keep the oceans running together, separate from each other, that the saltish remains separate from the sweet, and the sweet remains separate from saltish. So I request you to keep me away from the punishment of the hellfire and the lamentations of the one about to perish, and from the punishment of the grave. O Allah, I ask you of that goodness which is beyond my understanding and intention, and which I did not even ask. However, you promised this to anyone of your creation, or any goodness which you want to give to any of your slaves. I desire this and ask of you of it by your mercy, O sustainer of the universe. O you of firm promises and master of good deeds, I ask for your peace on the day of judgment and paradise on the day of eternity, to be among yours favorite and regular attendants of your court, frequently bowing and prostrating and fulfilling their promises. You are most kind and most loving, and no doubt you do what you will. O Allah, make me one who is guided aright and guides others aright. Do not misguide me, and do not make me misguide others. I may be in peace with your friends and enemy of your enemies. Those who love you, I should love them for that love of yours, and those who are against you, I should have enmity with them due to their enmity with you. O Allah, it is for us to supplicate and for you to accept. This is my effort, and reliance is on you. O Allah, put Noor in my heart and make my grave illuminated, and grant me Noor in front of me, Noor at my back, Noor on my right, Noor on my left, Noor above me, Noor below me. Your Noor be around me, and Noor in my ears, Noor in my eyes, Noor in every hair of mine, Noor in my skin, Noor in my flesh, Noor in my blood, and Noor in every bone of mine. O Allah, make my Noor enormous, grant me Noor, and make Noor for me. Unblemished is he whose covering is dignity itself, and whose word is dignified. Unblemished is he whose dress is nobility and honor. Unblemished is he, and none can be appropriately called unblemished besides him. Unblemished is he who is of great excellence and full of bounties. Unblemished is he who is of great dignity and generosity. Unblemished is he who is the possessor of great power and respect. Tirmizi. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, subhanaka allahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Subhanaka rabbil izzati amma yasifun, wa salamun alal mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah.